Today we are going to solve the relative questions of hyperbola which appeared in different exams of NTTest board examination and the competition exams APSC, MPSC and GRE. The most important question, what is mean by the rectangular hyperbola? According to the equation, standard equation of the hyperbola, when you put value of A is equal to B in hyperbola, the equation becomes x square over a square minus y square over a square is equal to 1. So after simplification of this equation, we get the equation x square minus y square is equal to a square. So this equation basically for the rectangular hyperbola. The next very important question which appears so many times in different university exams, what is the angle between the asymptotes? The value of the angle between asymptotes is 2tan inverse b over a. So I have a question x square over 9 minus y square over 3 is equal to 1. This is hyperbola, standard equation. I convert this equation in form of the square, x square over 3 square minus y square over square root 3 square is equal to 1. So if I want to find out angle between the asymptotes for this hyperbola, which is equal to 2tan inverse b over a, put the value of b and a in this equation, you will get 2tan inverse 1 over square root 3. And we know tan inverse 1 over square root 3 is equal to 30 degree. 30 degree when multiplied by 2 it becomes 60 degree. Now, the another question, important question for NTTest exams and board exams, angle between asymptotes for rectangular hyperbola. So, again, we will use this formula tan inverse b over a. In rectangular hyperbola, already I told you A equal to B. So when I put B by A, it becomes tan inverse 1. And we already know what is the value of tan at 1. It will be 45 degree. And when it multiplies by 2, it will be 90 degree. So it is clear that asymptotes in rectangular hyperbola intersect each other at right angle. So this is a very important question. Okay, take equation of hyperbola. According to this hyperbola, you can see the sketch will be like this. Transversal axis and conjugate axis. Comparing this equation by this hyperbola, and after comparing we will get a square is equal to 16, b square is equal to 49. So what is the value of a? That is basically plus minus 4, b equal to plus minus 7. I can replace it. Okay, plus minus 4 and plus minus 7. And in hyperbola, c square is equal to a square plus b square, that is equal to 16 plus 49 equal to 65. And after taking the square root, you will get plus minus square root 65. Okay, I can ask a question, what is the focus in this hyperbola? What is the vertex in this hyperbola? What is the eccentricity in this hyperbola? What is the trapezius in this hyperbola? So many other questions can be asked in this question. I can ask you length of the lateral rectum. I already told you in my previous lecture what is the length of the lateral rectum. So, according to this question, focus. What is the coordinate for foci for this hyperbola? That is 0 plus minus c. Okay, take the value of c, put there, you will get the focus or foci, because you have to focus in hyperbola vertices. What is the coordinates of the vertices? 0 plus minus c. I told you in my previous lecture. So put here value of a, take the value a, put here. Eccentricity means c over a. What is the value of c? And what is the value of a? You just put here and get the answer square root 65 over 4. Trapezius. Equation of the trapezius will be y equal to plus minus c over e square. You just put value of c and value of e and simplify this, you will get the trapezius equation. Thank you very much. another very important question. In different exams, equation will be given to you. That is the general equation of the second degree. Basically, there is two types of general equation of degree. If such type of the equation is given to you, ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0, with discriminant of this equation h square minus ab. The question will ask you that what this equation represents. Either this is hyperbola, parabola, circle or ellipse. So you will justify, you will give answer with the help of the discriminant. Agar aapke paas h square minus ab पॉजिटिव आ गया तो आपको जो भी इक्वेशन दी जाएगी वो हाइपरबोला होगी. अगर आपके पास डिस्क्रिमिनेंट h स्क्वायर माइनस ए बी इक्वल टू जीरो आ गया तो जो भी आपके पास इक्वेशन गिवन होगी वो पैराबोला होगी. अगर h स्क्वायर माइनस ए बी लेस देन जीरो मतलब नेगेटिव आ गया और जो आपके पास a और b है वो दोनों सेम हो, a और b क्या हो सेम, तो जो इक्वेशन आपको दी जाएगी वो आपके पास सर्कल कहलाएगी. इन द लास्ट केस अगर h स्क्वायर माइनस a भी लेस देन 0 है अगेन नेगेटिव, लेकिन a और b बराबर नहीं है चेंज है तो आपके पास रिजल्ट होगा वो एलिप्स होगा. अनदर फॉर्म ऑफ द सेकंड डिग्री दैट इज ax स्क्वायर प्लस by स्क्वायर प्लस gx प्लस fy प्लस c. यू कैन सी दिस इज equation with term product of xy. In this equation xy product not exist. So for this equation आपसे पूछा जा सकता है कि ये equation इस type की equation आप कौन एक किस इससे को represent कर रही है. तो अगर आपके पास a zero हो या b zero हो इन दोनों में से कोई coefficient zero हो तो आपके पास जो result आएगा वो parabola होगा. अगर आपके पास a b के बराबर ना हो लेकिन a और b सेम साइज रखे तो आपके पास जो रिजल्ट आएगा वो एलिप्स होगा. इन केस थ्री इफ a इक्वल टू b बट डज नॉट इक्वल टू 0, a और b दोनों बराबर हो लेकिन नॉन जीरो हो तो आपके पास जो भी इक्वेशन आपको इस फॉर्म में दी जाएगी है टाइप में दी जाएगी वो सर्कल कहलाएगी. a डज नॉट इक्वल टू b, a और b सेम नहीं है बट opposite sign, then the conic section will be hyperbola. Thank you very much.